Hi, I'm Mindy Peters, the Solutions Manager at SPI, and this is the start of a five-part series where I answer one of the questions that we get a lot at SPI, and that is, what should I do behind the scenes after I make a sale? For the purposes of this series, we are going to be looking at what happens after we make a course sale in Teachable. The five videos can be viewed as a series, or you can watch them individually. They'll each stand on their own. First, we're going to be looking at our thank you pages in Teachable. That's what this video is about, and it's the one that doesn't really touch on automations. After that, we'll be looking at how we use Zapier, the post-purchase automation that runs in our email service provider ConvertKit, how we use an automation to update our community platform, which is Circle, and finally, how we push a notification into our company Slack so that we know a purchase has just been made. In today's video, we are going to talk about thank you pages. Specifically, we'll be looking at Teachable's thank you pages, but I'm also going to talk about the thank you page experience in general. So if you're not using Teachable, some of what I have to say will still work for you. Let's get started. So here we are in our Teachable school, and I got to this section by clicking on courses, choosing my course, and then in this sidebar here, clicking on pages. And your thank you page editor is right at the bottom. Now in Teachable, you only get one thank you page, so all your different pricing plans are feeding into a single thank you page. That's important to keep in mind in case you run different sales or promotions. You want to make sure that the copy on your thank you page applies to all of your pricing plans and everybody who will be making a purchase, not just the recipients of a single sale. To edit, click on the edit button. Here's the Teachable thank you page editor, and if you've been around Teachable for a while, this looks a lot like the version 1 sales page editors. Let's see what this looks like on the front end. Here's what our students see when they land on our thank you page, and I will walk you through each element and what specifically we are attempting to achieve, and then we'll go back and look at the editor and I'll show you how we added those blocks into the page. The very first thing we see here at the top is a thank you and an order number. This is the most important section of the thank you page because it's achieving the primary purpose of this page, which is to tell the student, hey, your purchase went through. Your credit card was processed, your transaction was successful, here's your confirmation number. It's also saying thank you. Do not forget to say thank you when someone makes a purchase. They have trusted you with their money and with their time, and you are grateful for that, so don't forget to say it. Next, we have a small paragraph of text, and some people will never read it. That's okay, but for those that do, we're being very explicit about the next steps, which is to go down and click that green button, and that will get you into the course. We've also included a little pep talk, especially when people purchase during a promotion, when they're trying to make sure that they get something on sale before the sale expires. They may purchase a course, but not really be ready to dive into the content right away. We are trying to encourage students to just go in and watch that first video, because we know if they do go and watch that first video right away, they're far more likely to keep going and to start diving into the course content. Sure, we want to sell people a course, but even more than just selling someone a course, we want them to go through it. We want them to use it. We want to help them with that content. And so it's a disappointment to us if someone buys our course, but never takes action on the course, never starts to use it. And so this is a little pep talk to get people in and started on that course. The next section of the page is that button to get you into that course. The reason I have it below the block of text is just some of Teachable's spacing. They put a lot of buffer around it, and so it looks a little weird if it's above this block of course. That's why I have that order. Otherwise, probably ideally, I might move it up on top of that block. Scrolling down the page, I do have a little bit more content. I just have a very short FAQ, and these are questions that we tend to get emailed after somebody purchases the course, so I'm trying to answer them right here on the page. Now I have one other thank you page example to show you, and this has two more elements on the page. It has a video embedded in the page. Videos on your thank you page are a great idea. We've used them more in the past. Our videos just got a little outdated, so I've removed them, but we will be putting them back in soon. A video is a great way to just say thank you. Thank you for purchasing the course, and here's what you should do next. It can either take the place of that text that I've included, or it can be in addition to that text. It's just another way to thank people and try to get them to take that action. And then I also have an upsell offer on this thank you page. So let me show you what that looks like. You can see the top bit is the same, but then as we scroll down after our block of text, we have a video. And in this video, we are thanking people for their course purchase, but then we're also letting them know about an opportunity to add something onto their course. This was one of the first times that we were offering a boot camp for our students so that they could all go through the course over an 8-week period together with live Zoom sessions. And so we're describing that opportunity in the video. There's a little more copy about what you get if you make that purchase. And then this section right here is what Teachable calls the upsell offer. So we'll take a look at that in just a minute. So back to our first thank you page example. Here's what the builder looks like in Teachable. And when you open this up for the first time, you are going to see the purchase confirmation block and the proceed to course block. I would recommend keeping both of those blocks in there. Make sure to say thank you. And then you can add in additional content. You can see we've added in a rich text block. Here's how we do that. Just hover between the blocks and you'll see this little black insert new block button. Click on that. And you'll see some of the basic block types. Rich text is this A button here. Here's where you could add an image or a video. To see more examples, click on the dot, 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 and you'll see a whole bunch of other examples. I am also using the FAQ example from here. And later on, we'll be talking about that upsell offer. If you click that button and decide not to add something in, it can be a little hard to make this go away. Just click here. And this is still gonna kind of hang out there. If you wanna make it go away, make sure you've hit save. And then just reload your page. An important thing to know as you're making changes here, if you want to take a look at them, you hit the preview button, but you do need to hit save before you hit the preview button. You won't see the changes until you hit that save button. So I've added some text here in a rich text block. And if you need to put in any special styling, you can click on the HTML option here. And then you can work using HTML. Scrolling down the page, you'll see the FAQ block that I've added in here. And if you add in that block, Teachable is going to add in 3 default questions. You can just delete those or write over the top of them. To edit, just click on the pencil. That will let you edit your copy. Don't forget to hit save. If you want to remove any of the questions, just click on the trash can. If you need to add in additional questions, just click on add FAQ and it will add in an additional question for you. Teachable is going to suggest a couple of blocks. We'll talk about upsell in just a minute. And then in the settings section, here's where you can just customize the look just a little bit. I like to show navigation, but if you wanted to make the page really streamlined and make the only option on the page to click that continue to course button, you could get rid of the navigation bar and get rid of the footer. Just experiment with these, hit save, then hit preview, see what it does, see if you like it. Finally, if you are using any kind of ad tracking software, this is very old code that we actually aren't using anymore. In fact, I'm gonna go ahead and delete it. You can just hit the check mark here for add custom head code, and that will let you add in your Facebook tracking pixel or whatever type of code you need to let your ad tracking program know that a sale has been made. When you're done, go ahead and hit save and make sure to preview your changes. So here I am on the thank you page editor for that second thank you page that included the upsell offer. So here's the upsell offer block. And again, to get that, click on the button here, click on the dot, 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 and you'll see upsell offer as an option. So when you put in an upsell offer, you are swapping out that continue to course button with two buttons. One button will let the person make a purchase, and the other button will continue them to the course. And Teachable has a nice builder here. Now, I am getting a weird error message. I have plenty of other courses. I don't know why that's showing up, but everything is working, so I'm just gonna ignore that. First, you choose your course from the dropdown. So click on that, it'll show you all of your courses. Click on your course. Next, you'll click on your pricing plan, and it will, if you click here, it'll show you all of your pricing plan options. Additionally, you have the option to include a coupon, and that's really cool. So you could say in your upsell offer, like, buy now to get a $99 coupon applied or something. You can use your copy to make that feel really special and maybe make it feel like a one-time opportunity. So you can apply your coupon code here. First, you need to set that coupon code up. And just as a reminder, coupons can be set up in the left-hand sidebar here in your course. Just click on coupons and that's where you'll set up your coupon. So you can choose a coupon. And then here's where we customize the copy on those two buttons. So I have here, upgrade to the 8-week bootcamp and no thanks, continue to the EMM course. And make your decline button copy very clear that, like, here's how you get into your course. Be sure to hit save. And so just returning to that thank you page, we can see what that looks like. So that's how you customize your thank you page in Teachable. Now, I know if you're setting up your course in a rush, you're under a deadline, it can be tempting to not spend too much time on the thank you page. And certainly we have done that in the past where we haven't really put any extra thought into what goes on the Teachable page. But I'm going back through all of our courses right now and taking the time to really think about my customer and what their mindset is as they're hitting this page and try to provide a little bit of encouragement as well as say thank you. So if you don't have time to set it up right away when you're first launching your course, take the opportunity a few weeks down the line to come back and revisit it and make sure that it's a pleasant experience for your customer. In the next video, I will walk you through how SPI is using Zapier to deliver bonuses when a course is purchased. If you'd like to learn more about creating online courses, join the waitlist for our Heroic Online Courses course. The link is below, or go to smartpassiveincome.com/heroic.